Hello, hello, good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Hey, good evening. Welcome, everybody. Really nice to have you here. So, hope you had enjoyed yesterday's vacation. So, a la que hayan descansado un día extra ayer. So, espero lo hayan aprovechado. Nice. Okay, then. So, welcome to today's class. Really nice to be here with you. And, well, today we're going to start with something that maybe we haven't seen before. And, well, before we start with that, let's just take the attendance for the first time so that we can continue with the class without stopping about that. Let's see. So here we go. All righty then. So then we have, let me see. Wait. Okay. So let's see. So we have first Alison Ramos. She's not here.
Then we have. Quiero que apague ese tele, te vas a acostar ya. Por favor.
Va, a dormir, a dormir. Okay. Next we have Ana Beatriz Pineda.
Present.
Thank you very much, Anita. Then we have Ángel Balmore Aguilar. Ángel not here yet. So then we continue with Brenda Raquel Reyes. Not here, I guess. So we continue with Glenda Maricela Cuellar. Glenda Maricela, not here either, I guess. So then we continue with Iris Beatriz Cornejo.
I hear.
All right, thank you very much, Iris.
Present teacher.
Nice, thank you. So then we have Josué Vladimir Alvarenga. Josué, not here, I guess. So then we continue with, let's see, Carla María Beatriz Arana.
Present teacher.
Thank you very much, Carla María. Next we have Carla Yesenia Lanza.
Present.
Thank you very much, Carlita, nice. Next we have Lucy Nathalie Juárez.
Present.
Thank you very much, Lucy. Nice. Next person, we have Marilyn del Carmen Solis. Marilyn, not here, I guess. So we continue with Mauricio Emilio Alvarenga.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Emilio. Nice. Then we have Obed Alexander Alas.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Obed. Nice. Next person, I have Orfa Lisette Barrera. I guess she's not here yet. So then we continue with Rosa Vilma Landa Verde. Thank you very much, Vilma. Nice. Next person, I have Sonia Evelyn Iraeta.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Evelyn. Nice. Next person, Teresa Guadalupe Bonilla. Teresa, not here. So we continue with Jessica Melissa Oya.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Millie. Nice. So then we have, last but not least, Julissa Raquel Cruz.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Julie. Nice. Okay, then. So there you go. Let me see. All righty. So let's get started. Let's continue with today's lesson. Before we actually jump into the topic that we're going to study today, let's review something related to vocabulary. So let me see. Let's work in two groups. So let's see. All right. So we're going to work in two groups. In group number one, I have Anita, Emilio, Carlita Lanza, Carla Maria, Vilma, and Julie. And in group number two, I have Iris, Lucy, Obed, Evelyn, and Millie. All right, so you are group number two. So let's see, what are we going to do then? First things first, let me see. Let me just share my screen so that we can check this together. Here we go. All righty. So we're going to play something here. There you go. So the first thing we're going to do is that we're going to play a little memory game. So what's this memory game about? What are we going to check here? What's the point? We're going to try to, let me see. Match. Yes, Emilio, you have a question?
Creo que me puede dejar el grupo nosotros por un poquito como de los entre los últimos, porque fíjese que estoy todavía en el trabajo y no he terminado ahorita.
Oh, don't worry. Si no puede participar ahorita.
Cinco minutos. Ya casi.
Okay, nice. Okay, nice.
Sí, lo estoy escuchando, solo que ahorita no puedo utilizar el teléfono porque tengo un poquito ocupada las manitos, pero ya que sí, un poquito me falta.
Okay. No se preocupe, Emilio, no hay problema. Nice. Okay, then. So let's see. Okay, nice. So let's see. What are we going to do then? So here we have, before we start with the topic today, I want to review with you some vocabulary related to health issues or illnesses. So we're going to match the two pictures of the same health issue. Like in this case, we have a cramp. What's a cramp? Any ideas? Cramp. ¿Qué será? A cramp. No, nobody. Nadie. Le mando una pizza al que sepa ahorita. Let's see. A cramp is what we call calambres, right? So that we feel that it's terrible in our legs usually, or in our fingers, in our toes, I'm sorry. So those are cramps, right? So everybody hates cramps, I guess. So what do we have to do then? I need to look for the second picture with the same drawing. So I need to look for the other cramp. So no, here I have a stomachache, so All right, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to take turns and we're going to review some of these health issues. And then, everything's gonna make sense. We're going to join the two topics that we're going to study. So you'll see why we are starting with this. So let me just flip the cards. There you go. And let's start. So let's see. Let's start with group number one. Julie. De abajo para arriba, empecé.
Hello.
Hey there, hello.
Vale, así no voy a saber dónde están.
Es por Emilio. La primera tengo que adivinar. Emilio dijo que lo hiciera por tiempo.
Pero no conmigo. A ver. Sería... B1,
let's see. B1, headache.
Para adivinar dónde está la otra.
Ahí está, adivinar.
A6,
let's see. No match, a cough. So, No match yet. All right. So nice. Let's see. Group number two. This is your chance. Let's start with Meli.
Okay. All right. Just A1.
A1. Let's see. A cramp.
C6.
C6. Let's see. Would it be C6? Ay, a cold. So no much yet. All right, nice. So let's see. Group number one, we go back to you. Vilma.
Okay.
Let's see, Vilma.
B1.
B1, let's see. A headache.
B6.
B6, let's see. B6. Let's see, group number two, this is your chance. Evelyn.
Okay.
A2. Let's see, A2. A toothache.
With C. C4.
Let's see, like the explosive. Si se acuerda, let's see. Carla María.
C6.
Let's see.
Quiero ver.
C4. Let's see. C4. Are you sure?
Yes.
Nice. Very good. So then we have a cold, right? A cold is what we know in Spanish as un resfriado, right? So this is when we have a runny nose, fever sometimes. So that's a cold. Nice. Cold is also an adjective. Y no confundirlo con el adjetivo que también es helado o frío. Pero eso es otra cosa. También es como sustantivo, es una enfermedad y es resfriado. All right. So Carla María, you continue. Carla María, are you there?
Se me fue el internet.
I'm here. Okay, nice. Okay, Carla María, you choose two more because you made the match. Yeah.
Okay. C1,
let's see. C1. A cramp. El equipo le puede ayudar.
A1,
are you sure? Don't they say A1? Let's see. A1. Yes, very good. So there you go. A cramp, as we said, well, we mentioned that already, right? Un calambre. So very good. All right, so you continue.
Uy.
You are on fire.
Veamos.
B6, let's see. B6, stomachache.
A3,
sore throat. So there you go. But 2 points now. Very good. Group one. So let's see. Group number two. Let's continue with Obed.
Citrui.
Citrui, let's see. A headache. El grupo me puede ayudar.
B1.
B1? You sure? Okay.
B1. Yes.
Let's see. B1. Yes, very good. A headache. Excellent. So you continue. Ovid.
A6.
A cough.
I no idea.
Uh-huh. I guess we haven't seen this one.
C5.
Let's see. Just for fun. Oh, throat. Oh my gosh. There you go. So group 1, 2 points. Group 2, 1 point. So group number 1, Carlita Lanza.
C5.
C5. Uh-huh. A sore throat.
A3.
So you agree? Okay. So A3. Yes, very good. So a sore throat. Nice. A sore throat is what we call dolor de garganta, right? A sore throat. If we translate this literally, this would be something like garganta adolorida, but we call it dolor de garganta. So very good. So let's see. Carlita, you continue.
B5.
B5, let's see. An earache.
B3,
let's see. B3. Oh, yeah, fever. So no match. So let's see. Group number 2. Let's continue with Lucy.
Hello.
Hello, Lucy.
C2,
let's see. A toothache.
A2,
let's see. A2. Nice, very good. So a toothache, excellent. A toothache is one of the things that I hate the most in life. Dolor de diente, right? Dolor de muela. It can be also that as well. If you notice, here we repeat a pattern with the name of the illness. Se va repitiendo un patrón, ¿no? Eso del ache, al final, tooth, diente. Ache es como dolor. Entonces, dolor de diente. Then we have head, cabeza, ache, dolor de cabeza, right? De ahí el headache y el toothache, right? Headache, toothache. There you go. So nice. So Lucy, you continue.
Before.
Let's see. Before a fever.
B3.
All right. So she was seconded by someone there. Nice. Very good. A fever. Nice. Well, this one is self-explanatory, right? Fiebre. So a fever. Excellent. So let's see. So 3-3. So you continue. Lucy.
B2.
Let's see. An earache.
B5,
let's see. Yes, very good. Nice. So an earache. Earache is the same pattern. Ear, oído. So dolor de oído, earache. Yes. So nice. Very good.
So you continue, Lucy.
B6.
B6. Stomachache.
En A5.
A5. Si adivina esta, se lleva todo el premio. Let's see. Ay, ay, ay. It was the cough. All right. So, 4-3, right? So, group number one, it's your turn. So, let's see. Anita.
Hi.
Hey, Anita.
A6.
Let's see.
B6.
A cough and B6.
Ajá. No.
Es esa. Uy. Ya casi.
No.
No.
No, no es esa, compañera.
Ajá.
Es la A5.
A5. Julie says A5. What do you think, Anita?
Sí, esta es.
A5.
Sí, A5.
Sí.
Let's see, A5.
Pikachu.
Very good, nice.
Pikachu.
And the last one. Pikachu. B6. Stomachache. Very good. Nice. Excellent. Así, ya la andamos. Nice.
¿Cómo le hace el sapo?
Now,
rap.
In this case, we have these two last illnesses, right? A cough. A cough, tos, right? Tener tos, a cough. La pronunciación de esto puede sonar un poco rara, y porque esto termina como si fuera una F, right? Esa GH se pronuncia como si fuera una F. Cough, cough. En otras palabras, que tienen tal vez la misma combinación de letras, podría sonar diferente. Pero con esta palabra en particular, decimos o lo pronunciamos cough. So there you go. And then we have the last one, stomachache. So, literal, dolor de estómago, right? Stomachache. And that's pretty much it. There you go. All right. Now, speaking about illnesses and health problems, let's review something related to this through, well, some vocabulary here. So the topic that we're going to study today is related to, it's not exactly related to this, but I always like to mix it because it helps us to understand better something about, the topic that we're going to study later on. So let me see. Let's start with this review of vocabulary here. So for example, well, first things first, we have illnesses and diseases, right? An illness, we can say, is a state or occasion of being unwell. So in a general sense of the word. And a disease is an illness is something that I suffer from. If we translate this to Spanish, illness and disease, they are the same for us. Ambas significan enfermedades para nosotros, ¿no? Y we can say that an illness, we can catalog, for example, maybe an illness, a fever, a headache, etc. But then a disease is something specific like the flu, for example, la gripe, or any other disease, right? I mean, specific diseases. But if we translate this to Spanish, pretty much it's the same, right? Now, let's see. What are some examples of these health issues. So we have some problems. These are some expressions that we use to talk about symptoms, right? For example, I say, I have a stomachache, or I have an earache. I suffer from headaches, for example, or that causes an stomachache, or the food that I ate caused me a stomachache. So these three problems, I guess we studied them already: stomachache, earache, and headache. Now, I can also use the expression I have a sore throat, right? Dolor de garganta. I can say I have a broken arm, brazo roto, yes. An injured elbow. Here we have this expression that can be also combined, or I might also use injury. Injury, herida, right? Or let's say lesión. It can be both. So, an injured elbow, como un codo lastimado, right? Elbow, codo. No le van a decir elbow a alguien que es tacaño, ¿verdad? So, no, that's stingy in English. No, no le van a decir codo. All right, so it's not elbow. So, in this case, an injured elbow. Then we have also the cough, right? Or a cough. I have a cough. Tengo tos. I have a cough. Also, we have rash. Rash. Do you know what that means? What's rash?
Como sarpullido.
Sarpullido. Exactly. Sarpullido, right? So, es como las ronchitas que salen. That's rash. A veces la gente dice, es que a mí eso me da rash, ¿verdad? O sea, como de, como que no, ¿verdad? So, that's where the expression comes from. So, it's sarpullido. All right. So, then we have, wait, let me erase this. We have some other illnesses, well, some other symptoms of diseases, like eczema. Eczema is like this type of allergy that some people get when they eat some or certain food, for example, they got this eczema. Also, we have a runny nose. A runny nose, a lo buen salvadoreño es andar mocoso, right? O tener la nariz y tapada. That's a runny nose. That's how we express it. We can also have here a cut, right? Una cortada, a cut. A bruise. A bruise is like un morete, un moretón, a bruise. So that's after we injured our body, or when we fell down, we usually got a bruise, right? And then we have a wart. A wart, here, no es suegra. Nah. A wart is verruga, right? Verruga. So that thing that she has in her nose, so that's a wart. So there you go. Nice. Let's see what else. So if we continue, some more expressions here. A cold and the flu. Un resfriado y la gripe, right? The flu usually is a little bit stronger than the cold. The flu usually has more symptoms and it can last longer than the cold. So it's a little bit different. Also, some expressions that I can use: to be in bed with a temperature. A temperature is the same that a fever, right? So I'm in bed with a fever or a temperature. Estar en cama con fiebre, right? I'm in bed with temperature. To suffer from a cold, or to go down with the flu, como sentirse mal o sufrir de, padecer de algo, no, de a disease. Vocabulary related to the cold and the flu: to blow one's nose, sonarse la nariz, right? To blow one's nose. So it's when you do that with a handkerchief. To sneeze is when you, well, literally estornudar, right? To sneeze. So there you go. Some other problems that we might have to graze one's knees, rasparse, right? To rasparse las rodillas. Kids, for example, well, children, they are very prone to grazing their knees all the time. So raspones. Swell, when something is swollen, usually no lo ocupamos así como swell, sino que lo ocupamos combinado como a swollen, let's say, leg. Usualmente lo ocupamos así, como swollen. Swollen es hinchado, right? Por ejemplo, una pierna hinchada, a swollen leg. So, hinchar no ocupamos como eso en un problema, sino que lo que decimos es hinchado. So that is swollen. And then we have also to sprain one's ankle. Doblar, se le fue la tapita y a la muchacha. So, to sprain one's ankle, es como doblarse el tobillo. So, that must hurt. And then we have to feel dizzy, right? Dizzy, mareado, dizzy. To feel sick, it's like if you are going to throw up. So, cuando decimos I feel sick, usualmente es como me siento mal, más tirándole a quizá voy a vomitar, ¿verdad? So, that is to feel sick. And, ya el resultado, to throw up, right? To throw up, vomitar, como dice la gente. So, there you go. And also, well, to cough, right? Toser, right? We already saw that one before. And let me see. So we have some more. Here, this is just some examples on how to use them. Aquí, ejemplos de, por ejemplo, cómo describir mis síntomas. Si yo voy donde el doctor, yo le digo, I have, y yo puedo ocupar las diferentes expresiones, ¿no? Here we have something that maybe we didn't check. A pain in my back, dolor de espalda, right? A pain in my back. And I can combine it. So a pain in my back, a pain in my tooth, a pain in my head, etc., etc. I have a broken sprain or twist. Aquí puedo decir doblado. Bueno, estos dos son parecidos, ¿no? Doblados o quebrado, broken. Ankle, tobillo, wrist, muñeca, right? Eso en la mano. No decimos doll, ¿verdad? La muñeca de la mano no es doll, this is wrist. Then we have, I have a cold or runny nose, I have fever, I have high temperature or a sore throat. I feel sick or I'm feeling nauseous. Nauseous is the same, but it's like con nauseas. And then we have also, I have a bruise, a cut, a graze, a wound, wound, herida. So, a ver, una cortadita es a cut, ¿verdad? Pero una herida mayor, digamos, no sé, ¿verdad? Me caí, no sé, quebré algo, le caí encima algo de vidrio, esas ya son wounds. O si tuvimos un accidente en el carro, la gente queda herida, wounded. And then we have to catch a cold, es que me pegó un resfriado, ¿verdad? Como que agarré un resfriado. I caught a cold. There you go. And now talking about medicine, we have tablets, tablets or pills. Tabletas o pastillas, right? Tablets, pills. How do I write it? Here we have pills. There you go. Also we have drops. Gotas, drops. Si lo combinamos, usualmente de lo que hablamos cuando hablamos de gotas es o gotas para los ojos o gotas para el oído. So that is eye drops, right? Eye drops or ear drops.
It's we combine it with the words, with the parts of the body. Then we have a shot or an injection, right? Y una inyección literal. Y la inyección es a través de una syringe, una jeringa, and a needle, la aguja, right? Syrup, jarabe, right? Syrup. Then we have creams. It needs no explanation, I guess. And here we have a band-aid. A band-aid, curita, right? Band-aid. There you go. Mm-hmm. All right. Some tools, right? We have a scales, a vasculas, scales. We have a wheelchair when people are too weak or when people can't walk. We also have crutches, muletas, and a thermometer, right? Thermometers, very important when you have kids too. Or now with COVID, right, that you want to check sometimes when you don't feel okay, you check your temperature with a thermometer. And some people who work in the field, he will have a doctor or a physician. We also have a nurse or a surgeon, or a cirujano, del doctor normal. El cirujano o el enfermero o enfermera, nurse. And that's it. Some health advice. Exercise regularly, eat healthy food, brush your teeth, sleep early, have regular medical checkup. A medical checkup es como una revisión del médico, una consulta con el médico. That's a checkup. And we also have stay in bed for some time, right? Relax, go on a diet. Ponerse a dieta, decimos go on a diet. So I'm on a diet, decimos estoy a dieta. I'm on a diet. Y siempre lo ocupamos con on. Then we have drink plenty of fruit or juice or water. Tomar mucha agua o jugo. Take off mixture, medicine, or tablets, and have an x-ray in case you broke some part of your body there. Let's see what else. And that's it, right? So we're not going to complete this one. We have our own exercise that we are going to complete now. So, any questions so far? Questions? Something? Are we cool? So far, so good? Okay, nice. So let me see. Now. Okay, so let's have a little practice here. Let's start with, let's see how much you remember from the vocabulary that we just checked. So let me share my screen. There you go. So let's play a Kahoot to review this vocabulary and to see if you remember something about the symptoms and the medicine that we can take depending on the health problem here. So here we go. This is the PIN number we're going to use. So there you go. All right, there we have. Carla Maria, Vilma, nice. Oved, nice. Thank you. Natalie. I'm sorry.
¿La práctica de qué se va a tratar? ¿De qué tema?
De lo que acabamos de ver, de health issues. Yes.
Okay.
Nice. All right. And we have Anita as well. Melly, nice. Waiting for some more people. Emilio, Carlita Lanza, nice. Okay, so let's see. So if you haven't been able to connect, well, you still can do it during the game, all right? So let's see, let's get started with this. So here we go. So let's talk about health problems. So first things first. First, the definition, right? Health problems, that's a state in which you are unable to function normally and without pain. Synonyms, it is caused by a person's genetic makeup, lifestyle behaviors, exposure to toxic substances, or other reasons. So, here we go. First, what do you do if you don't feel well? What do? You, personally, call a doctor, stay in bed, take an aspirin, or take any other medicine. What do? ¿Qué haces cuando estás enfermo? Así con honestidad. Let's see. Let's see, let's see. Oh my God, you call doctors. Good. So, solo una persona se automedica. Como yo. So, there you go. Yo puro limón con miel todo. Nice. Excellent. So, there you go. So, here's just like a little survey, right? So, most of you, you go to the doctor, you call a doctor. And that's nice. That's actually the best, right? Ahora sí. Let's see. Double points. Esta vale doble. When we have an earache, what do we do? I have an earache. What do I do? Ay, ay, ay. So it says, what do we do when we have an earache? So we can take painkillers, right? So, si podemos llamar al doctor, we can call a doctor. Pero tal vez lo ideal sería ir, right? Going to the doctor, that would be the best. But if we don't have something, or if we cannot go in that moment, probably at night, take painkillers. What are painkillers? Se me fue la palabra. En español se me olvidó.
Like Tylenol.
Exactly. Ajá. Son lo que tomamos para el dolor, right? Todo eso que tomamos.
Analgésico.
Analgésico, that's the word. I'm sorry. Yes. Ajá. I'm sorry.
Advil,
yeah, that's another example. Advil, Tylenol, Panadol, right? So those are painkillers. So they help us to cope with pain. So there you go. So let's see. Oved, very good. Evelyn, Anita, Carla Maria, and Vilma. Let's see the next one. When we have a toothache, we see when we have a toothache. Mm-hmm. What do you do? Where do you go? And yes, there you go. So when we have a toothache, we go and see a dentist. Very good, dentist. All right, Ovid, sit in the first place. Anita, Evelyn, Carla Maria, and Natalie. Let's see the next one. If we need an operation, we need to see a... Tienen que escribir la respuesta. What do we need? Ay, ¿cómo se escribía? ¿Cómo
no
se
sé
escribía?
Cómo se escribía.
No lo copié, no lo copié. Ajá. How do you call those special doctors? Right. Ay, ay, ay. Surgeon or doctor? The correct answer is
surgeon.
There you go. Cirujano, right? Surgeon. If you need a surgery or an operation, you need a surgeon. So there you go. Let's see. All right, there you go. So still Ovid in first place, Anita, Evelyn, Yuli going up, and Carla Maria. Here we go with the next one. If we have an eye infection, we need to see a or an. Which one do you think that we should see? And nice, there you go. So it's el azul, no? So that's not the one. So the first one, it's a vet, right? A veterinary. So ahí un gato tiene, así que no era. El segundo, no, right? So he's working on his mouth, en la boca le está haciendo algo ahí. So I guess he's a dentist. So the last one here, estaba como preparando bisturí, cosas así. So probably that's a surgeon. So this one, the yellow one, is the correct one. If that's an eye doctor, we can call it a eye doctor or ophthalmologist, right? As we would call it in Spanish as well. So the yellow one. Let's see. So we have Ovid still in the first place. Evelyn going up. Then we have Anita, Carla Maria on fire, and Carlita Lanza. Next. Opción múltiple, vale doble. Let's see. If we need glasses, we need to see a or an. Si necesito lentes, who do I need to go with?
Seleccionar dos, solo una.
Puedes seleccionar más de una. Debes seleccionar más de una. Let's see, let's see. And nice, very good, excellent. So, exactly. If I need glasses, then I need to go with the optician. Or I guess that's the same as an ophthalmologist. So excellent. Glasses, lentes, right? Y no confundir con glass o glasses de vasos. Y, se escribe igual, pero el contexto le va a decir, ¿verdad? Y no si necesito vasos voy al súper. No, so si necesito lentes, right? In this case, nice. So let's see. All right, so Ovid is still in the first place. Evelyn y Carlita Lanza going up. Medley going up. And Anita. Next one, let's see. So when we have a cough, we take medicine.
true or false. When we have a cough, we take medicine. That's true or false, and that is, of course, true, right? So we should. So, hay una persona que no toma medicina cuando tiene tos. So there you go. All right. So, nice. This is like the best thing we should do. What type of medicine do we take? If I have a cough, what do I need? What was this in the picture? What's that? What's the name?
Expectorante.
Syrup. Syrup. Exactly. What I really hear in syrup. Yes. Un jarabe, right? It's expectorante. Good. All right. Let's see. Same positions. Next one. Puzzle. So place the answers in the correct order. Ordene la oración. Muscles. And time. Ay, 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 ay. Just 20% of the people got it correct. So you should call a doctor if you have measles. What are measles? Paperas, right? So when you are like this, like Kiko, so then you need to call a doctor. That's really painful. So there you go. Here we also use this structure, should. Should lo utilizo siempre como para dar consejos. Por ejemplo, aquí dice deberías llamar a un doctor. So you should go to the doctor. You should take a pill. You should go to sleep, etc., etc. It's always to give advice, consejos, deberías, right? Nice. Let's see. Same positions. Number 10, when we have a cold, this is tricky. No lo sé, Rick. When we have a cold, we take vitamin C. Yes, there's no cure or any specific cure for the cold or the flu, but just we can take things to deal with the symptoms. In general, the usual thing or the most recommended thing, take vitamin C, right? There you go. Let's see. All right, Natalie, going up. Almost finishing. When we have a temperature, so yes, we take an aspirin. A painkiller, it's like, nosotros no, tal vez nos tomamos un acetaminofén y es para el dolor y para la fiebre también, ¿no? So, in general, we can say, or we would say that an aspirin is more specific maybe for the temperature, but in our culture, I guess this is the same, or it's actually more popular to take a painkiller rather than an aspirin. So there you go. But anyway, so there you go. Natalie on fire going up. And Millie also going up. The last one.
multi-select, double points, opción múltiple. When we have a splitting headache, we... Cuando tenemos un dolor de cabeza fuerte. Multiple choice. So we have... And there you go. So yeah, it's the two of them, right? So we have, or we can have a painkiller or an aspirin for a headache. So there you go. All right. So final scores. Let's see. Third place, Natalie. Nice. Second, Evelyn. Very good. And the first place goes to Oven. There you go. So kudos for you. Special mention to Carlita Lanza and Carla Maria. Nice. Okay, very good, very good. Let's see. Okay then. Now that we are more familiar with this, I'll explain to you why is it that we are reviewing this. But I'm going to take attendance before we start so that I don't lose track of the time. So let's see. Déjese me voy a pasar por alto. So, tomamos asistencia por segunda vez. Here we go. So, Alison Gabriela Ramos. Not here, I guess. So then we start, we continue with Ana Beatriz Pineda.
Present.
Thank you very much, Anita. Next, Ángel Balmore Aguilar. Ángel. Lo vi por ahí conectado. Sí, está conectado. Quizás...
I heard.
Yes, okay, nice. Thank you, Angel. All right, so then we continue with Brenda Raquel Reyes. Not here, I guess. So we continue with Glenda Maricela Cuellar. Glenda, not here. So I continue with Iris Beatriz Cornejo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. It is, then we have Josué Vladimir Alvarenga. Josué, not here. So we move on to Carla María Beatriz Arana.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. Y Carla María. Then I have Carla Yesenia Lanza. Carlita Lanza. Por ahí está, pero quizás no tiene audio ahorita. Ok. So I continue then.
Oh, no.
Hello.
Hola, teacher.
Yes, Carlita Lanza, nice.
Ah, present.
Nice, thank you. Ok. Next, we have Lucy, Natalie Juárez.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Lucy, nice. Then I have, let me see, Marilyn del Carmen Solís. Marilyn, I guess she's having some issues there. So next person, we have Mauricio Emilio Alvarenga.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Emilio, nice. Next person, Obed Alexander Alas.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Obed. Next person, Orfa Lizeth Barrera.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Orfa. Nice. Then we have Rosa Vilma Landa Verde.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Vilma. Next, Sonia Evelyn Iraeta. Thank you very much, Evelyn. Good. Then we have Teresa Guadalupe Bonilla. I guess she's not here. So next person is Jessica Melissa Oya.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Millie.
And present, teacher.
Last but not least, Julissa Raquel Cruz.
Present, teacher.
Nice, nice, very good. Okay, then. So let's see. Let's continue with the next topic that is somehow related to health issues. I'll explain you why, but first I have a video for you. Today we're going to talk a little bit about imperatives. So why or what? Well, first, what are imperatives? Let me show you here. Let me see. Wait, I lost it. All right. So in this video that you're going to see here, we're going to talk a little bit about imperative sentences. So imperatives are, for example, whenever we give some people commands, directions, etc., etc. So let me see. I can share it here with you. Wait. Jesus, wait. Okay, this is the one, I guess. Alrighty, so here we go. All right. So let's see. So I guess you can see my screen now. So let's check. Is something related to imperatives? And then I'll explain to you a couple of things related to this topic. So here we go. Listen.
Hello again. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you are doing great. Welcome back to the fourth lesson of grammar, which is about imperative. Okay, we will see the use, the form, and an exercise for practice as usual. So let's start by the use of the verb, of the imperative. We use imperative to give orders, instructions, or commands, okay? So we use it to give orders, instructions, and commands. For example, don't talk, stand up, sit down, don't smoke. So now let's move to the form of the imperative. We have here in the table, we have the form and the example, and we have, of course, two types of sentences, the affirmative sentence and the negative sentence. Okay, so let's start by the affirmative sentence. We have here in the affirmative, the form will be the following base form of the verb, infinitive. Okay, so we put the verb in the infinitive form. We don't change the verb, we don't conjugate the verb, we just put it in the infinitive. For example, open your book. So the verb here is open. It remains open, okay? We don't add s or nothing. We just leave it as it is. So open your book. Close your book. Read the text. And now let's move to the negative form. We have here don't plus base form of the verb, infinitive. Okay, so as usual, you already know that negative sentence is like an answer no. Okay, so don't plus base form of the verb. Verb is not conjugated, is in the infinitive form. For example, we have here in the affirmative, open your book. So the negative is don't, okay? Don't open your book. Don't open your book. So you have here, close your book. Negative will be don't close your book. And the affirmative, read the text. Here in the negative, don't read the text. Okay, don't read the text. So just we add at the beginning of the sentence, don't, okay? Plus the verb, of course. Now, let's move to the practice. We have here an exercise. As you can see, affirmative, negative. We already have an example. Come here, okay? This is affirmative, come here. Negative, don't come here. Don't come here. So we have here the second sentence, don't talk, in the negative. So what do you think the affirmative form will be? So if we have here, don't talk, what is gonna be? So we have the third, close your books. What do you think the negative will be? And the last one is, don't stand up. You have to find the affirmative form of this imperative sentence or imperative phrase. So this was the end of the video, which is about the fourth lesson of English grammar, imperative. I hope you guys enjoy watching it. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. And when you're done.
Yeah. All right. So there you go. So what exactly are imperatives? What's all this about imperatives? Let me show you something here related to that. And here we have imperatives, right? So when do we use them? This is like in Spanish, imperativos, right? With imperatives, the idea that we transmit is that we are giving instructions or that we are expressing a request or something stronger, a command. Con estos imperativos, ¿para qué nos sirven? Puedo dar consejos, como lo hacía con should, cuando alguien en las oraciones que vimos en el Kahoot, puedo usarlos para dar instrucciones. Esto no puede servir en el trabajo, o literal para dar una orden, right? Si queremos verlo de esa manera. So, whenever I have these cases, then I use imperatives. Now, if you notice, whenever we use imperatives, we say something like, let me give you an example. For example, I say, sit down, right? That's like an instruction, that's an order, that's a command. So I say, sit down. ¿Será esto una oración? No le pongamos signo de admiración porque soy gritado. Solo puntito. Sit down. ¿Será esto una oración completa en inglés? What do you think? Yes or no? Este es un ejemplo de una oración completa. He plays soccer, right? What about this one? Sit down.
No es completa.
No, it's not complete. ¿Qué le falta?
No indica realmente a quién le está diciendo sit down.
So no parece como si no tuviera un sujeto, ¿no? La oración. So it's like if I just had the verb. Parece, right? In English, whenever we use imperatives, we use something that is a tacit subject, as we use it also in Spanish, como un sujeto tácito en español, que no está ahí o no se ve, pero digamos, sí está, ¿no? Si yo le digo a alguien, sit down, es como si yo dijera, hey, you, sit down. Right? You, sit down. Le digo esa indicación a una persona específica. Por ejemplo, a ti, ¿no? Señalo usualmente a la persona y le digo, sit down. ¿Quién? You, right? So, you is going to be always the subject whenever we use imperatives. Siempre ese you va a ser el sujeto de nuestras oraciones en el modo imperativo. Entonces, es una oración completa, una indicación, digamos, en el modo imperativo. Sí, right. Aunque no se vea el sujeto, está ahí. There you go. All right. So let me see. Let me just clear this. All right. Now, I can use this in the singular form. Like if I'm just talking to one person, I can say, open the door, please. Open the door. When I say, or when I mention the word imperative or giving orders, doesn't mean that I'm going to yell at people, right? Y eso no es imperativo, no es que le voy a gritar a la gente, mire, vaya a hacer tal cosa, no. Y me sirve para indicaciones, ¿verdad? Y puedo ser, de hecho, hasta amable. Open the door, please. Right? Le doy una indicación a alguien de que abra la puerta. Open the door, please. Then we have... I can also talk to more than one person and I can say, let's play soccer. Hey, let's play soccer. So we as a team or we people, hey, let's play soccer. This expression is very common, right? Hey, let's dance, let's eat, let's go, let's play, etc., etc. So this can be used with two or more people, yeah? Esta indicación la puedo dar a dos o más personas. So, that is pretty much it. When I use the affirmative form of the imperatives, I say, for example, turn off the computer. Turn off the computer. So, what do I need then? Aquí me olvido del third person singular rule. No lo voy a ocupar. So, usualmente tengo, bueno, no usualmente, siempre tengo el verbo en la forma base, right? So, como acá, turn off, apaguen la compu, turn off the computer. This is in the affirmative form. If I have the affirmative form plural, hey, let's go, in this case, to the library. So, ese let's go no es contracción de is. Es contracción de let us. Es como de... this actually doesn't have a translation in Spanish. So if I want to use this in the complete form, I could say let us go to the library. Pero casi nadie ocupa la forma completa. Siempre, usualmente lo decimos como let's go, let's eat, let's do whatever, right? Y lo mismo. Después de la expresión let's, ocupo el verbo en la forma base, como let's go, and the complement or the object here, let's go, where? To the library. So that's the object or the complement in the sentence. Mm-hmm. Then we have negative form. With the negative form, here I use don't, like don't smoke. Don't smoke. It's a clear direction to somebody, right? Hey, don't smoke. So what do I need? Do not, plus a verb in the base form as well. Como haríamos o como formaríamos el negativo del presente simple. So don't or do not. And if it's plural, then we would say, let's not make noise. Let's not go. Let's not drink tonight, right? So, con la expresión let's, solo le vamos a agregar el not. So, there you go. All right, any questions so far? Preguntas, dudas. For example, if I say, I have a headache. What can I do? What is your recommendation using imperatives? What would you say?
Take a pill.
Take a pill, exactly. So here is what I use, the imperative form. You take a pill. I have a headache, take a pill. What if I say, I have a stomachache. I have a stomachache. What can I have for that?
See a doctor.
Could be see a doctor. See a doctor or go to the doctor, right? Very good. What if I have, let's say, I'm stressed out. I'm stressed out. What can I do?
Just relax.
Just relax. There you go. Just relax, right? Just relax. So there you go. So here, this is how we use imperatives. You see, we just use the verb in the base form plus something, right? The recommendation that we are trying to do. Can I use should for this? Yeah, I can use should. Si voy a ocupar should, y como algunos ejemplos que vimos en el Kahoot, ahí sí ocupo todo completo, ¿no? Aquí podría decir, en vez de take a pill, you should take a pill. Deberías tomarte una pastilla. O you should see a doctor. O you should relax a little bit, for example. But usually we would say something, if you want to use or say something shorter, just use the imperative, right? Take a pill, take a chill pill, et cetera, et cetera. All right, let's see if you got the idea here. So I have a little practice for you. Now, speaking about some examples in which we can use, let's see. Imperatives. We're going to work in a little practice. So I'm going to share the link here in the chat in Zoom. But first, I'm going to create groups. So let me see. So let's work in groups of three people. So here we go. All right, so we're going to work in groups of three people. Group number one is going to be Glenda, Iris, and Meli. So you're working together. Number two, Orfa, Evelyn, and Yuli. You're working together. Number three, Carla Maria, Natalie, and Oved. So you're working together. Number four, Anita, Emilio, and Vilma. You're working together. And the last one, Angel, Carlita Lanza, and Marilyn. So there you go. So what are you going to do? Let me share the link here. Wait, here it is. Ahí está. And let me explain it to you before I send you to work. So here you have some directions, right, on how to use imperatives. And here you have some situations. On each situation next to it, you have what you should or shouldn't do. For example, in number one, it says, so loud, the baby is sleeping. It is said not to speak. ¿Qué tendría que escribir acá entonces en el espacio? It seems it's negative. So what do I need?
Mm-hmm. Speak.
Speak. Affirmative.
Yes.
Don't talk. Don't speak.
Ajá, como la canción. Don't speak so loud. The baby is sleeping, right? So there you go. Exactly. So this is what you're going to do. You're going to choose if the sentence goes with affirmative or negative imperative. So.
Teacher.
Ajá.
Teacher. Me voy a desconectar un ratito porque voy saliendo del trabajo. Okay. Yo llego a la casa como unos 3-4 minutos y me vuelvo a conectar.
Va, chivísimo. Excelente. Nice.
Okay,
corre, Robert, corre. Nice. All right, then. So I'm opening the small rooms, the breakout rooms, so that you can start working together. And I'm going to send the link to WhatsApp in no time, so that you can also check it from your phone. So you have like more or less 10 minutes to finish, and then we come back. All right? So let's see. If you need some help, just let me know.
Teacher, cuando me salí para meterme al link en WhatsApp, fíjese que ya no pude ingresar nuevamente a la plataforma, a mi grupo.
Ok, vamos a ver, Emilio, ¿con quién estaba trabajando? Con...
Grupo 4.
Grupo 4. ¿Con quién estaba?
Los nombres sí, no me quedaron.
Lo voy a meter en el grupo 3 porque creo que el 4... me tocó deshacerlo porque no había nadie. So, lo voy a mandar al 3.
Ok.
Carla María y Natalie.
Hello, hello.
Hello, teacher.
Hey there.
Can you help us?
Yes, tell me.
Es que no tenemos claro cómo tenemos que colocar acá.
Ahí, y no es he does not to speak. Acuérdense que estamos dando una indicación a alguien. Cuando le decimos a alguien, digamos, cuando ocupamos el imperativo con alguien, decimos, no hables tan fuerte, diríamos acá. No hables.
Así.
Don't speak. Exacto. There you go. Nunca vamos a ocupar el doesn't en el modo imperativo. Solo sería don't o el verbo en la forma base.
Don't speak.
Uh-huh. Por ejemplo,
y en el
número dos, por ejemplo, pass me the salt, please. Exactly.
Solo sería sí,
porque solo estamos dando la indicación a la otra persona.
Ya.
Okay.
Está bien.
Nice.
Gracias.
Ok, nice.
Bye.
Emilio, ¿me escucha? Emilio, not there. Okay, so if Emilio is not there, Obed, veo que ya se conectó. Nice. Okay, Obed, so I'm going to send you to work with a group. So I'm going to send you with Carlita. So that's group number 5. So there you go.
Thank you.
Okay, Obed.
Lo voy a hacer yo solo, teacher.
¿Y qué le pasó, Emilio? Veo que se le está conectando.
Sí, es que me está fallando el internet, pero sí, lo voy a hacer solo.
Va, no hay problema, Emilio. Está bien. Ok.
Bueno.
Nice.
Hello.
Hola.
Hi there.
Teacher, tenemos una duda.
A ver.
Es que no la entendimos bien. Sí, me dice Evelyn de que sí eso, de que lo que está a la par lo vamos a poner en negativo o afirmativo, pero que ya está la respuesta, así como está el orden, o no, o hay que buscar realmente la
no,
respuesta.
Así como está el orden, es la 4 con la 4, la 5 con la 5.
Ah, pues yes. Sabe lo correcto ella.
Yes. Uh-huh. Nice. Ay, sure. Yes. Ok, good. En la número 4, this is to pay. Acá yo diría pay attention to what your parents say. Hay que agregarle por ahí attention en la número 4.
Nice.
Okay, nice, good.
No le llamamos lógica.
Sí, hay que agregarle la palabra ahí. Okay.
Pero no en todas, ¿verdad?
No, diría que no. Creo que solo ahí se les olvidó, creo que poner la palabrita. Yeah, nice.
Okay. Gracias.
Okay. Hey there. So you finished? You're done?
Yes.
Nice. Perfect. So let's wait just for the rest then so that they return. Let's wait just a couple of minutes. Okay, then. So let's see. Let's wait for the rest. I guess we're still missing a couple of people. Okay. All right, so now we're here. Very good. Okay, then. So just don't forget to send the homework, well, the homework, the activity that we just completed. And let's see. There was just one thing in number four. What it says, well, let me share it here so that we can all see it. In number four, it said to pay, right? But we're missing a word. So to pay attention, it should have been. Creo que aquí se les olvidó agregar la palabra attention. So pay attention to what your parents say. Pon atención a lo que dicen tus padres. So don't worry, right? Si solo ustedes pusieron pay, no fue error suyo, no era que faltaba la palabra acá en las opciones. Y quiero ver en la número 6, por ahí vi que alguien la tenía mala, alguien le salió también mala, la número 6. ¿O no?
Sí, salió mala.
Sí, ¿verdad? Ah, no. Pues entonces creo que es un problema de la página. Si pusieron write y write your name at the bottom, así era, right? So don't worry, no es que la tuvieran mala o que hubieran escrito mal algo o la estructura no era correcta, no era eso, creo que es un problema de la live worksheet y al momento de tomar la respuesta. De ahí creo que las demás no nos dieron mayor problema. Ok, nice. So, very good. Any questions or doubts about how or when to use imperatives after this little practice we had, or no? Better now? Okay, so this is pretty much, let's say, easy to use. It's not something that complicated. So I guess we're not going to have like too much a problem with this. Now, there was a homework that was supposed to be for yesterday. But since we canceled yesterday's class, let's see or let's listen to some of you with that homework. So, por ahí había una tarea pendiente, si se recuerdan, que era para ayer. Pero let's see, voluntaria que quisieran leer la tarea.
Here.
All right, let's see. Ovid, nice.
Solo déjenme verlo. Que no me acuerdo el orden de las oraciones.
Cool. Okay.
First, always.
Okay, let's see.
I always drink coffee in the morning.
Uh-huh.
Next, often.
Mm-hmm.
I often straighten my hair.
Ah, straighten your hair. So, uh-huh. with an iron or with a brush?
Yeah, with an iron.
Oh, very good. Nice.
And next, sometimes.
Uh-huh.
I sometimes run in the morning.
Oh, very good. Nice.
Next, I hardly ever.
Hardly
I'm
ever.
Hardly ever.
Hardly ever.
Hardly ever.
Hardly. Hardly.
Hardly. Hardly.
There you go.
Yes.
Yes.
Hardly ever have fried banana for the breakfast.
Okay. Very good.
And I never miss a day at the gym.
Wow. Very good. So you're very disciplined with the gym.
Yes.
All right. Nice. Excellent. Thank you very much for that, Ovid. Nice. Obed, select another person.
Oh, Lucy Juarez.
All right, let's see. Lucy, what do you prefer, Lucy or Natalie?
Natalie,
okay, so Natalie will be. Nice, so Natalie, what about your synthesis? Let's see.
Yes, I always try to my job. Uh-huh. I often read in bed at night.
Uh-huh.
I sometimes listen to music.
Mm-hmm.
I hardly ever watch TV.
Uh-huh.
And the last one, I never go to travel other country.
You never travel to different countries. Yeah. Okay. Nice. What do you read at night? What do you often read at night?
It's like a novel.
Uh-huh.
Oh. It's right from Michelle Obama.
Oh, good. What's the name of the book?
And Homecoming, I think.
Homecoming.
I'm not reading all days.
Oh, I see.
Sometimes.
Every now and then. Okay. Nice. Very good. So, Natalie, you select another person.
Carla Maria.
Carla Maria. Okay, let's see.
Okay, I always get up early in the morning.
Uh-huh, very good.
I often drive my car to my work.
Uh-huh, very good.
I sometimes go to the shopping mall.
Okay, nice.
I hardly ever cook fish in my house.
Oh, you don't like to cook fish?
No.
No. Okay.
And I never watch horror movie. I don't like it.
You don't like them?
No.
Why? Too scary?
Yes,
very much. Okay. I don't watch it because I fall asleep. Okay, nice. Very good. So Carla Maria, you select another person.
Okay. Let's see. Carlita Lanza.
Okay, Carlita Lanza, La Tocaya. Let's see.
No, yo hice la tarea.
Y la dejó en la casa, Carlita Lanza.
Bueno, voy a decir.
Okay, let's see. Give it a try.
I always drive to my job and uh-huh. sometimes go to the cinema.
Mm-hmm.
I usually breakfast. I have a breakfast in my job in the morning.
Uh-huh.
And I have my era porque a una.
Yes, exactly.
Tiene
una con hardly ever.
Hardly ever. Mm-hmm. ¿Qué es hardly ever? Se me olvidó.
Casi nunca.
Hardly ever.
Uh-huh.
Then in my job.
I hardly ever.
Hardly ever, casi nunca bailo uh-huh. en mi trabajo. A veces sí, cuando hay alguien bien.
Oh, I see. Uh-huh.
Sí,
ajá. Uh-huh. Hardly ever means job, huh?
Never. Never, que nunca hago, que a ver. ay, qué difícil.
No, come on.
Yo no sé qué. No sé qué. Yo sé, never.
I never walk to work, for example. And you?
Never, because I driving for my
job. Okay. There you go. So let's see, Carlita Lanza, you select another person.
¿Quién hizo la tarea?
No, no preguntas. Usted la hace como la asustaron a usted.
Pues para que no. Nadie levantó la mano. De lo que no.
Julie.
Hi.
Hey there.
I always set my email every morning. Often do inventories. Sometimes I call clients.
Call clients?
I hardly ever eat lunch at 12 noon.
Hardly ever?
Never cook the menu.
You never?
Never cook the menu.
You never cook the menu? You never cook? No. What did you want to say there? ¿Qué quería decir en la última?
Yo nunca cocino el menú del comedor donde trabajo.
Ah, okay, all right. So there you go. Excellent. Okay, very good, Julie. So, choose another person.
Angel?
Angel, let's see, Angel.
Hi.
Okay.
Okay, okay. I always listen to music. My favorite song in the morning.
So you always often, listen to your favorite song in the mornings. Often.
Often I prepare reports.
You often prepare reports?
Teacher, no había hecho la tarea. Ahorita estoy.
¿En serio?
La estoy. Sí, sí.
Era, va bien. Ahí ya dijo la de Owen, es que, la de Offen.
Sí.
Me dio
risa lo que hizo Carlita Lanza. Preguntó quién había hecho la tarea. I sometimes check my
nos está compartiendo
correo electrónico. ¿Hola?
Nos está compartiendo, Obed, nos está compartiendo pantalla. Peligroso, Obed, ahí está.
Sorry.
Nice, don't worry. Okay, Angel, I'm sorry.
Okay. I hardly ever watch TV.
Watch TV. Okay. You want to try the last one?
I never cook in the at court.
At work.
At court. Yeah.
At work. Very good. Okay. There you go. Not bad. So thank you, Angel. Okay. Then. So the rest of you, I guess we will have to pass tomorrow because we don't have like too much time. El resto me queda pendiente ahí para mañana. Now, por lo de la clase de ayer que tuvimos que cancelar, vamos a mover un poco la fecha, incluso con las tareas y todo eso. Las tareas las estábamos entregando, quiero ver, lunes, si no mal recuerdo, creo que lo estábamos subiendo, pero como nos corrimos, ¿verdad? Entonces no sería las tareas lunes como último día, sino que martes y un día después. So, igual, traten de hacerlas todos los días. O sea,
después de cada clase su tarea. Nice. Ok, también por ahí vamos a tener el examen, el primer examen, el midterm, creo que la próxima semana, si no mal recuerdo, creo que nos tocaría entonces martes, no, el mismo día que entregamos o que tendríamos que tener ya todas las tareas. Bueno, vienen los temas prácticamente que ustedes repasan en las tareas, ahí mismo van estudiando para el examen prácticamente. So, there you go. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Y pasamos lista, entonces, let me see. Here we go. So, hoy le corresponde quedarse a, let me see, Ovid. Y se puede quedar unos minutitos después de la clase. Ovid? Está en mute.
Sí, sí, sí puedo.
Okay, nice, Ovid, nice, very good. Okay then, so here we go with the attendance. So number one, Alison Gabriela Ramos, creo que no está acá. So we continue with Ana Beatriz Pineda.
Present.
Thank you very much, Anita. Next, Ángel Balmore Aguilar.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Angel. Next, Brenda Raquel Reyes. Creo que no está por acá. So next, Glenda Maricela Cuellar.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. Glenda, next, Iris Beatriz Cornejo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much. Iris, then I have Josué Vladimir Alvarenga. Creo que no está. So we continue with Carla María Beatriz Arana.
Present.
Thank you very much. Y Carla María. Next, Carla Yesenia Lanza.
Present.
Thank you very much, Carlita. Y next, Lucy Natalie Juárez.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much. Y Natalie, next person, y Madeline del Carmen Solís. Creo que está por ahí conectada. So we continue with Mauricio Emilio Alvarenga.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Emilio. Next, Obed Alexander Alas.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Obed. Nice. Next, Orfa Lizeth Barrera.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much, Orfa. Nice. Next, I have Rosa Vilma Landa Verde.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Vilma. Next, I have Sonia Evelyn Iraeta.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Evelyn. Next, Teresa Guadalupe Bonilla. Creo que no está presente. So next person, Jessica Melissa Oya.
Present, teacher.
Thank you very much, Meli. And last but not least, Julissa Raquel Cruz.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Julie. Okay, guys. So thank you very much for being a part of today's class. As always, a pleasure for me to be here with you. Have a good night and get some rest, and I'll see you tomorrow. So take care.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Good night. Bye. 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 Okay. Vaya, Uber, solo deme unos minutitos acá. Let's see. Ahí está. Ok, Uber, so, a ver, ¿qué tal, cómo está?
Bien, bien.
Cansado, me imagino.
Cansado, sí.
Ok, nice. Y bueno, todos los días veo que le ha tocado como quedarse a trabajar hasta tarde.
Sí, es que digamos, como tengo una semana, entro de 7 y salgo a las 4 de la tarde. Entonces esa semana no tengo problema con las clases.
Ajá.
Y a la siguiente semana me toca entrar a la 1 de la tarde y salir a las 9 de la noche.
Híjoles.
Entonces, sí, ahí es donde se me complica un poquito porque a veces estoy en el hotel y hay huéspedes que llegan o algo que tengo que ver, entonces estoy
anda corriendo.
Audífonos. Y como me llegan a traer también, entonces por eso a veces me desconecto y me vuelvo a conectar.
Ah, ya. Pero vive cerca del hotel.
Sí, del hotel estoy como en carro 3 minutos lo más en carro.
Ah, súper, súper cerca. Ajá,
sí, qué bueno.
Cerca. Nice, qué bueno. Ok, sí. So, súper. So, y Ovid, y bueno, estos minutitos que nos quedamos al final de la clase, es, bueno, en el caso que usted tenga preguntas, pueden ser preguntas de los temas que hemos visto, creo que hasta ahorita, y más que todo, creo que la primera unidad, la primera semana ha sido un repaso del módulo 1, de todo lo que vimos del Simple Present. Y usted entró de una sola vez al módulo 2, o hizo el módulo 1 en otra parte, o con otro teacher, ¿cómo fue la cosa?
No, de una vez me ubicaron en el módulo 2, solo me mandaron como un test. Ajá. Y ahí ya me ubicaron en el módulo 2.
Ah, súper, súper, ok. ¿Y hasta ahorita cómo ha sentido, verdad? ¿Le ha dado problema algún tema o son cositas que usted ya sabía?
No, ninguno. No, como a mí, bueno, en particular siempre me ha gustado el idioma, ¿va? Y trato de entenderlo y siento yo que lo entiendo bastante. Ajá. O sea, a veces lo que se me dificulta un poquito son las pronunciaciones de algunas palabras. Uh-huh. O el hecho de pensar la palabra y cambiarla al idioma, porque eso es lo que más siento yo que me cuesta, como pensar. Ajá. Rápido.
Ajá. Okay. Sí, en ese caso, Ovid, y de hecho yo he notado que sí entiende bastante cuando digamos, le pregunto o le hablo en inglés, creo que sí me entiende bastante. Y lo que me gusta es que se anima a contestar, o sea, y sigue, trata de mantener la conversación en inglés, lo cual, bueno, muy importante, ¿no? Parte de irse acostumbrando al idioma, como decíamos. Quizás una de las cosas que más se nos hace un poco más difícil como en soltarnos en eso del speaking, es que no tenemos a alguien con quien practicar, ¿verdad? Entonces, uh-huh, usualmente no hablamos el inglés, ¿verdad? O sea, y es ahí donde a veces cuesta que nos llegue la palabra, la idea o la estructura que nosotros queremos decir, al no estar acostumbrados. Y tratar, bueno, primero que nada, tratar de aprovechar el momento de la clase, que si se puedo participar, participo, si es de hablar, hablo, ¿verdad? Etcétera, etcétera. Y cuando no estoy en clase, digamos, cuando estoy yo solo, ¿qué puedo hacer? Y primero, yo siempre recomiendo, ¿verdad? Empaparse un poquito del idioma, por otro lado, digamos, en la televisión, en YouTube, series, tanta cosa que ahora que podemos ver en inglés y que no solo nos ayuda en el aspecto del idioma, sino que también nos da como una idea de lo que es también la cultura de ellos. Y cuando uno aprende un idioma, también aprende, tiene que aprender un poco de la cultura de ese país. Y pues ahí uno se va familiarizando con ciertas expresiones que tal vez al memorizarlas, y nosotros las tiramos de un solo, ¿no? Hay una teoría del idioma que dice que nosotros aprendemos en chunks. Chunks son como trozos o pedazos. Eso es lo que significa la palabra. Entonces, por ejemplo, cuando nos preguntan, how are you? A uno lo primero que se le viene a la mente es el I'm fine, thank you, ¿verdad? Porque eso nos han acostumbrado así, casi que nos han condicionado así desde pequeños, ¿no? Y a responder así. Entonces, eso es un chunk que ya tenemos internalizado acá. Lo mismo cuando podemos aprender otros chunks así. Por ejemplo, si yo le digo a alguien, hey, how you doing? I'm doing fine. What about you, man? So, me empiezo a agarrar chunks para otras cosas que cuando yo los necesito, boom, salen casi que en automático.
En automático.
Ajá, exacto. Y eso se logra, bueno, escuchando, es con lo que le decía, ¿no? Escuchando, repitiendo, Si yo pongo un video, creo que por ahí se lo mencioné un día de estos, lo pongo más de una vez, ¿verdad? A veces ponemos un video en inglés y decimos, por obra y gracia del Espíritu Santo, me lo voy a aprender o voy a aprender algo, ¿verdad? De ese video. Y una vez lo vi.
Sí. Incluso ya todas las series que miro las he pasado en inglés.
Qué bueno.
Para irme familiarizando. Música siempre me ha gustado escuchar. Yo siento que eso es lo que me ayuda a entenderlo. Más porque cuando escucho las canciones, las traduzco en español, las voy buscando para irlas traduciendo, para ir entendiendo lo que va hablando la música, lo que dice la canción. Entonces, es lo que trato de hacer.
Nice, vaya, esas cositas ayudan, ¿no? Yo siempre les digo también, busquen algo que les guste, ¿no? Como la música, series que a ustedes les gusten, videos en YouTube que hablen de cosas que a ustedes les interesa. Eso creo que es la principal motivación de uno, el querer entender algo que a uno le gusta.
Le guste.
Ajá, eso nos motiva un montón. Y de esas cositas es que vamos sacando vocabulario, cómo pronunciar, o sea, agarrar vocabulario no es solo de, anoté la palabra, busqué la traducción y ahí murió. Aprender el vocabulario es buscar también cómo se pronuncia, ¿verdad? O sea, hoy tenemos la ventaja de que en Google podemos poner una palabra y la podemos escuchar cómo se pronuncia.
¿Cómo se pronuncia?
Ajá. Y ahí no es necesario escribir algo bien científico. Ajá, exacto. Ajá. Algo tan complicado, sino que así como yo lo escuché, así me escribo ahí una nota, ¿verdad? Si, por ejemplo, people, ¿verdad? Puedo poner people, literalmente people, o sea, así la escucho, así se pronuncia, y ahí dejo mi nota en paréntesis de que esa es la pronunciación de la palabra. Y luego volver, ¿no? Repasar esas notas, repasar esos apuntes que hemos hecho, y como revisar nuestra colección de palabras que vamos haciendo. A mí me funcionaba mucho leer. Y yo de las lecturas sacaba un montón de palabras, o sea, de un libro en inglés, llené un cuaderno, que era un libro chiquito, llené un cuaderno y me aprendí todas esas palabras, todas esas expresiones. Buscaba, por ejemplo, cómo meter esas palabras en oraciones ya en la vida real y todo eso, ¿no? Ser curioso con eso de las palabras y más que todo en cosas que sabemos que nos pueden servir en nuestro entorno laboral, por ejemplo, que nosotros vamos buscando y...
Eso, precisamente.
Eso, ¿no? Ajá. Exacto.
Sí, porque vamos, ahí en el hotel llega bastante gente de extranjero, ¿va? Y hablan bastante. El idioma que más hablan es el inglés. Ajá. Entonces, como le digo, les entiendo, digamos, cuando me piden una toalla, que agua... o necesitan algo, yo les entiendo bastante qué tipo de cuarto y todo. A la hora de hablar con ellos es que ya me
ya cuando le piden una recomendación y a dónde pueden ir,
ajá, cosas así. Ahí sí, cosas más
espontáneas, ajá,
sí, ahí sí, pero sí, la clase me gusta bastante, estoy aprendiendo bastante, estoy aprendiendo bastante y creo que se me está quitando poco a poco la pena también, ¿vale?
Excelente.
La pronunciación.
Nice, qué bueno, me alegra mucho escuchar eso, realmente eso se trata, ¿no? Que ustedes se sientan cómodos y de que poco a poco, ¿no? Se vayan soltando y pues yo creo que con paciencia llegamos a ese nivel que queremos, ¿no? Así que... Okay. Bueno, de mi parte, lo felicito por el momento. Creo que vamos bien con usted. No tengo así como algo negativo que decir de usted o algo que deba mejorar. Simplemente seguir así, ¿no? Mejorar un poquito tal vez la pronunciación, pero eso yo sé que viene con la práctica. Y pues nada, ¿no? Adelante. Y pues qué bueno que le guste.
Gracias, teacher.
Okay, Owen. So thank you very much for your time. Have a good night and I'll see you tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Take care.
See you. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.